Hi, my name is Martin Verdonk and you're watching Martin Verdonk Master Sessions live from AAA Music. With Lex and Brian here in the studio, taking care of the great sound as always. In this episode, we have a special guest, Adam Hawley, on guitar. On drums, Sietse Huisman. On bass, Ronnie Jonker. On keyboards, Tico Pierhagen. On saxophone, Jan Koper. Enjoy.
The same exact thing every time, but just in general, it helps it kind of just settle.
Adam Holly, welcome to the Maarten Verdonk Master Sessions. It's a big pleasure to have you here on the program. It's the first time today we met and we played together.
Yes, this is amazing. Thank you so much. This honor is all mine.
Well, and more than welcome, more than welcome.
And we made a lot of good music today.
Oh, yeah. Well, actually, we played four great tunes.
Yeah.
And actually, we played the tunes that... This is your latest album, right?
That's great. One, Adam, it's my Harding. Only album. It's my debut.
The first one,
yeah,
also.
Yeah, this is the first, yeah.
Just the beginning. Great album. And we played four tunes today of that album. Tell me a little bit about the process of recording your album.
Of course, yeah. Well, it's interesting. This album I started on, well, now 12 years ago. I have 10 years stuck in my head because 10 years from when it came out, but now it's been out a couple years. So, but yeah, I was in college at the University of Southern California, which is in Los Angeles, and always wanted to make a record. I've always been a big fan of course, first George Benson, and then Norman Brown, and then Kirk Whalum, Richard, Gerald Albright, and so on. All the legends of contemporary jazz. I always wanted to make a record like that. I started on it, and three of the songs that made the cut in this record I actually wrote back in around 2005, 2006. Mm-hmm. And then I just got busy. You know, I started touring. My first group I toured with was the Manhattan Transfer, and I toured with them for 4 years. And then I got married, had a son. So me and my wife, Kat, have Adam Jr., who's now 8.
Right. Your wife also, she's a singer, right?
Exactly, yeah. She's an amazing vocalist.
She's also on the album.
And she is, yeah. She's on number 11,
yeah.
Love Song. And she's also on Joyride, number 8.
Cool.
And she sings in my show quite often, too.
Right.
And which is good. You only need to hear so much guitar. So so it's nice to break it up a little bit and have her come out. And the audience always loves her. But yeah, at any rate, yes, I started on it, then took a break. Then a few years ago, I got the itch again. I was like, I got to put a record out. And I had started touring with a lot of the legends of contemporary jazz. And I always feel so honored to work with them, such as Dave Koz,
yeah.
Brian Culbertson, Huge Groove, Richard Elliott, Gerald Albright, and so on.
I think Brian and
a few of them are on here.
On the CD also, yeah.
And this is kind of what I'm kind of driving at with what I was talking about right now, is that once I started working with a lot of these artists, it kind of just opened the door, and the possibilities and opportunity were there to make the record I always wanted to. And so sometimes it's all about timing, and the timing was right in 2016 to release this as opposed to 10 years ago, because, you know, your infrastructure gets together, you meet people, you know where to go to record. And then a lot of the artists I'd been touring with, I was able to get to play on my record, which of course never would have happened in 2006 or whatever. So yes, I was able to get Brian Culbertson, Gerald Albright, Michael Linkton, Eric Darius, and Huge Groove all as guest artists, which I felt so fortunate.
Yeah, fantastic.
And so these are all people I toured with just as their guitar player. And then I said, hey, can you help me out?
Yeah,
and so I guess I did a decent job when I was touring with them, because they all said yes. So I feel fortunate.
Right. That's later. So second verse, 1, 2, 3. Second verse. 1, 2, 3. So wait.
Sounds great.
Jan Koper.
Martin.
Welcome here at the Martin Verdonk Master Sessions.
Thanks.
It's really great to have you on the program. Man, we've known each other for 40 years.
40 years it is, yes.
Really. We know each other from high school. You started to play the saxophone. I just started to play percussion.
Yeah.
And we have been playing over the years. Well, we haven't played that much together.
We
did some tours with Doemar, a famous band here in the Netherlands.
Yeah.
And Nick and Simon, also a famous artist here.
Yeah.
So how are you doing?
Much better. Thank you.
much better. That means that.
No, I was remembering the time that we were studying on the conservatory, and we would play on the streets. You remember?
Yeah, we played on the streets.
Yeah. It was
actually making good money.
We were making good money. Yeah. It was fun. It was like 40 guilders an hour or something each.
Yeah.
So
better than most gigs we do.
Yeah, I don't know where that came from. That it's much better now.
Yeah, I don't know.
Well, I just did a great song just now with Adam.
Yeah, Adam Hawley.
So that's why I feel.
Is it the first time that you played with Adam?
Yeah.
And you know the other guys, I think.
Of course. Yeah. But to play with Adam is an honor because he plays with such a great saxophone players normally.
Right.
Gerald Albright, Dave Koz.
Dave Koz.
Yeah. So that's.
And now he plays with Jan Koper.
That's true.
The one and only.
Yeah.
I remember you had a very popular band a couple of years ago called the Cooper Test.
Yeah.
Do they still exist?
No. Well, we sort of had an idea to come together again after 20 years. And but it's a bit of a problem because everybody is working in other bands.
Right.
But we're trying. And the June 24th we will have a concert, reunion concert.
Oh, wow, reunion.
And where? Yeah. We don't know yet.
Okay.
Norsey Jazz Club it was.
There's no Norsey Jazz Club anymore.
We will let everybody know where.
Yeah. Besides being a great saxophone player, I also heard that you're doing a lot of arrangements for string quartets and movie scores and
stuff. That's correct.
Like that. Tell me a little bit about that.
Well, it's very rewarding to make music for other artists that I love, like Shirma Rouse. Right. She has an album, and
she was on one of the episodes also.
Oh, okay,
Shirma
cool.
Rouse. Yeah,
nice. And to add some violins, to add some horns, that's a really nice job. And also when I work for theater or film, I can compose whatever I like. And that's beautiful. I do not need like fusion or jazz. I can do anything. And I'd love to make the combination of different styles. And it's a lot of freedom and it's nice work. Yeah.
Great. Well, I hope to see you. I hope I can invite you for one of the other episodes.
Yes, sure.
It will be fun to have you.
Yeah.
And so thank you so much. Thanks again.
Thank you, Martin, for having me.
And we'll keep in touch. Anyway.
Yes, anyway.
Okay, thank you. Jan Koper, ladies and gentlemen.
Bye-bye.
What you're going to play? So you're going to have one down here.
Yeah.
What if you did?
I just like to... During the chords, like high strings. Yeah.
And then on the bridge, then you can do the chords like you were doing.
Yeah.
Chord and chord.
Okay, yeah. So during...
And then when we get to the end chorus...
Yeah.
Woo! Yeah, there we go, there! We're in there! You don't play one. So, chord. Yeah, you don't do one. I think let's just keep the same, just roads and strings. Because the roads just takes up more space.
if I look at your career, I mean, you're a very versatile player. Because if you tour with Manhattan Transfer, but you also played with the Backstreet Boys, Jennifer Lopez, Dave Koz, there's a wide variety of... How do you manage that?
Yeah.
Is that also, you know, did you start it in your early years playing jazz and then went to pop music, or...
It's always been a variety for me. So I always say I'm kind of schizophrenic a little bit because I just love everything.
Right.
So I've never become, I would say, a master in any of these styles. Mm-hmm. But, you know, when I got to L.A., I saw so many great guitar players, and it was like, man, where do I fit in?
Right.
And it's important to find your niche, regardless if it's you're a specialist, like you're just the most amazing flamenco guitar player ever, mm-hmm. you know. So I was like, man, well, you know, I'm good at a lot of things. Why don't I... keep working at that, raise all of them to a pretty good level, and then also my reading too. I started on classical piano at the age of 8,
right.
So that kind of gave me a head start in my sight reading and reading ability. So you started putting all those together, and I saw there's an opportunity in LA where I could be kind of the jack of all trades, play a lot of different styles well, and then also read, because there's very few guitar players that read
right.
well and yeah. can play contemporary music styles. Yes.
Yeah. Well, thank you. Thanks again.
Yeah,
thank you so much. People can find you. Have a website.
Of course.
AdamHawley.com.
It's very easy. It's just my name.
Yeah, and you're on Facebook.
Yes.
And great album.
Thank you so
much.
And
I love the songs that we did.
Thank you.
And thanks again for
And likewise,
for
thank you for what you added. It was incredible.
Well,
so,
you know,
this was fun.
It's all about love for the music.
Exactly.
So, yeah. Thanks again, Adam.
All right.
See you soon. Bye-bye.
Right.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Ronnie Jonker, Sietse Huisman and Tycho Pierhagen, welcome here at the Maarten Verdonk Master Sessions. And thank you guys so much for being a part of this program.
Thanks, man.
Tycho, let me start with you. we've known each other for, I think, about 10 years.
Probably, yeah. More
and actually, we played last week. In Austria, we did a festival together. It was really nice, really enjoyed it.
Yeah.
And so tell me a little bit about your background.
Well, I'm from Colombia. I was born in Colombia. I live all my life in Holland, and I think we met like 10 years ago. And since then, we were playing a lot together, and he was playing on my last CD.
On your last CD, yeah.
Which I recorded in Colombia with Colombian musicians. It's a mixture of Colombia folkloric jazz music. I play with Richard Smith a lot. That's why we met. This is one of the connections with Adam Hawley. So, yeah, my life is in Holland, Colombia, and in the States,
yeah,
Los Angeles.
Yeah. Your musical education, are you coming from a classical background or jazz?
I grew up with the Beatles, actually. My parents had all
That's pretty classical.
Yeah. My parents had all those black LPs, and I was listening to them over and over. Then I started to study classical piano. I went to the conservatoria in Hilversum. That's where I live now. And then I went to the conservatory in Rotterdam. I had some Latin jazz lessons. So I studied composition and jazz piano. That's basically it. Yeah.
Cool. Sietse, we also know each other for many, many years.
We go far back.
many years. Unfortunately, we don't play that much together.
No.
But we did some really nice concerts and tours. So always enjoy playing with you. And today also we had some really nice grooves going on. You also made a couple of really nice CDs, and I think you have your own studio at your home?
I have my own studio, my own recording stuff, yeah.
Do you also do a lot of sessions at home for people that they send the files and...
Yeah, that's what I do for a lot of musicians and artists, you know, they send me their files and I play their drums for them.
Mm-hmm.
That's really cool.
Yeah.
But besides that, of course, I'm a session player, as you do.
Yeah.
Play with a lot of my nice artists and projects like this.
Yeah. If you could choose a style of music that you would prefer to play, let's say, every day, what kind of music would you play?
Oh, man, that's a difficult question because, you know, my taste is wide. I think passion and musician skillship is...
basically what I like, and I prefer a lot of styles actually. Mm-hmm. I don't have an outspoken style that I prefer, but what we did today is basically something that I really like.
Yeah,
fusion kind of stuff, but singer-songwriter stuff. I have a big love for a lot of styles, and I like to work with a lot of people in different situations.
Yeah, you also worked a lot with musicians in that style, like smooth jazz, fusion jazz, like also Richard Smith, I think.
Yeah, Richard Smith is basically the a big connection, and because of Richard, we now play with Adam, actually.
Yeah.
And Richard contacted me and says, hey, I know this great guitar player, and you guys should hook up.
Right.
And now we're here.
We also played together with Alan Hines. And Jeff Kashua.
Tom Braxton,
yeah, Bob Baldwin.
Yeah.
We did some really
But we
nice
go far back, man.
Yeah, we did some
really
nice
I think the first
nice
gig
concert.
We did was somewhere in 1990, something
oh.
like that.
Oh. Oops.
Oh, yeah.
No. Oh, okay. Yeah. Next.
Next. Yeah.
Well, Ronnie Jonker on bass. the first time I think we met was with some concerts that we did with Jeff Kashua.
Yeah, that was
the saxophone player from the Rippingtons.
Yes.
And I also think that you've been playing with Anna Popovich for a long time, right?
Yeah. I toured with her for exclusively for 6 years, from 2006 until 12, I think. And then later on, I only do the European tours. So I still do some work with her, some tours. But that's a great experience. I learned a lot during those days.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely.
So what is your main, who was your main influence?
Ooh, well.
Probably a lot of bass players, but.
A lot of bass players. I like all these guys. I like a lot of styles. I mean, I grew up with, playing rock music and listening to rock music. My brothers taught me about music, learning how to play music, but also listening to different stuff. So I grew up with Queen. Mm. It was different. But then when I went to the music school, to the conservatory, I learned about jazz, and that's when I first learned about Jaco Pastorius, of course. And also a big hero of mine is Gary Willis from Tribal Tech. But I do like Bootsy, because, man, that's all about the one. I love that stuff.
So and, you have Gary Willis and you have Bootsy.
Yeah, man.
exactly.
So, I would like to combine, especially in music like this with Adam Hawley or stuff, I like to combine that, you know, the one and the funky style with some, melodic and maybe a little virtuoso in there. Not too much, but... Yeah, I like that. I like a broad range.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So again, thank you so much, and I hope to see you in the show more often. Maybe, you know, with some other artist. And thanks again, and hopefully till we meet again.
Yeah, absolutely. Thank you, Martin.
Okay.
Thank you, Martin.
Yeah. See you next time.
Oh, you're here. Oh, yeah. Yeah. The end. Do.
I'll find the spot.
Yeah. Okay.
Slow.
Look at that.
Woo!
Look at that.
Wow.
Cool. So let's just try one and see what happens.
Well, that's it for now. Hope you enjoyed the music. And don't forget to tune in on the next episode of Marty Verdonk Master Sessions live from AAA Music. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, Marty Verdonk Master Sessions. Bye-bye.